During Adolf Hitler's life, there were no fewer than 42 serious threats to his life. This number is almost certainly bigger, as the 42 assassination attempts are only the ones that have been uncovered by historians. In Europe, there's certainly more information about groups of people who would meet to plan out the assassination and murder of the Führer of Germany, but these are yet to be discovered. Today, we're going to look at one of the most famous attempts and plans devised to murder and assassinate Adolf Hitler. Today, we look at the British plan, Operation Foxley. To support the channel, please make sure to subscribe. Since Hitler rose to power, and even before this, there have been attempts on his life. However, these only intensified during the Second World War, and when things were turning against the Germans, these were ramped up in the Führer's own country. One example of this is the July the 20th plot. This plot occurred in 1944, and is possibly the most famous attempt on Hitler's life, when Klaus von Stauffenberg planted a bomb inside Hitler's Wolf's Lair headquarters in Rastenburg, East Prussia. However, in that same year, the British had also planned to assassinate Hitler, around the same month of the Stauffenberg bomb plot. The British SOE, the Special Operations Executive, had been set up in 1940 to take part in all actions of subversion and sabotage against the enemy overseas. Whilst Europe was under German occupation, SOE would regularly commit acts of sabotage in those occupied countries. They became known as Churchill's Secret Army, and they collaborated with resistance groups as well. One of the first attempts by the British to assassinate Hitler was planned to make use of SOE's extensive experience in derailing trains using explosives. They had initially been doing this all over Europe, disrupting supplies reaching German troops. A plan initially was devised to bomb and derail Hitler's train America. However, this was dropped as Hitler's schedule was too unpredictable, as train stations were only informed of his arrival a few minutes before the train would arrive. Also, plans were considered to poison the water supply on board Hitler's train using a tasteless but lethal poison, but this was considered too complicated as the plan needed an inside man. However, a plan was devised to assassinate Hitler, and this was given the designation Operation Foxley. It was ultimately considered that a sniper attack was the best method of killing the Führer, as it gave the best chances of succeeding. During summer in 1944, a member of Hitler's personal guard at his mountain retreat, the Berghof, had been taken prisoner in Normandy. Hitler's mountain retreat and house in the Obersalzberg region was his pride and joy, and he would often spend months here entertaining guests, as well as coordinating the German war effort. We've covered the Berghof before, and its subsequent bombing, so I'll link these in the description. The German soldier who was captured in Normandy revealed that at the Berghof, Hitler always took a 20-minute walk in the mornings around 10 a.m. During this time, the Führer liked to be left alone, and the guards would leave him unprotected near some woods, where he would be out of sight from the guardhouses and sentry posts. He also revealed that when Hitler was at the Berghof, a Nazi flag was flown in a nearby town from a cafe. Using this information, a plan was devised to assassinate Hitler during his morning exercise, and particularly as he walked unprotected to the tea house on the Maslaner Kopf Hill. It was a consistent and concrete routine that Hitler took part in daily, which would make it seemingly easy to undertake. The scheme would have called on SOE to parachute a German-speaking Pole and a British sniper into Austria. From this, an inside man was recruited, a man whose uncle was a Nazi prisoner of war. He was a shopkeeper who lived in Salzburg, which was around 20 kilometers away. This shopkeeper named Dieser was extremely anti-Nazi and went under the alias Heidenthaler. He would shelter the agents and transport them into Berchtesgaden and the Obersalzberg region where the Berghof was situated, whilst the agents were disguised as mounting German troops. From here, they would make their approach to the vantage point to take out the Führer. A sniper was recruited by SOE and briefed of the mission with the plan being submitted. The sniper practiced by firing at moving dummies with a Kar-98K rifle, fitted with a Mauser telescopic sight. The Kar-98 was the standard rifle of the Wehrmacht. Using anything but a German weapon could have roused suspicion should the assassins be stopped in the area. The sniper would become familiar with the weapon, and specifically familiar with taking out targets at a distance. Also, the sniper would be given a 9mm Luger pistol, fitted with a British-made silencer, for him to deal with any threats during their approach to the target, so plans and training was very much taking place for the mission. However, despite the proposals for the operation being submitted in November 1943, the operation was never authorised because of the opposition in the British government as to whether removing Hitler from commanding the German army was actually worth it. During this stage of the war, the Führer was doing more good for the Allies than bad, and his decisions were seemingly making Germany head towards defeat. One of the key individuals that didn't support the plan was the deputy head of SOE's German directorate, Lieutenant Colonel Ronald Thornley. He argued that Germany was almost defeated and claimed Hitler could be subject to martyrdom for the Germans if he was killed. He also said that it could give rise to a post-war myth that Germany would have won the war if Hitler wouldn't have been killed in an underhand way. This could have then allowed further tensions with Germany to rise. On the other side of the coin, though, was his superior, Field Marshal Sir Gerald Templar, and even Winston Churchill supported this plan. When the Allies went to war with Nazi Germany, they intended not only to defeat the Germans in military combat, but to also destroy National Socialism as a political ideology in Europe. Making Hitler a martyr went against this idea, as he would have been venerated by the masses for years to come. As a consequence, Operation Foxley was not authorised. It was also considered that a lack of reliable intelligence about Hitler's routine would have possibly scuppered the mission. It was estimated, however, by historians that a possible assassination would have taken place on the 13th or 14th of July 1944. Interestingly, Hitler left the Berghof for the final time on the 14th of July 1944, and he never returned to this area after this. So who would have known if Operation Foxley would have been successful? My opinion is it would have been hugely risky for a sniper to carry out the attack. The initial parachuting into the area would have been extremely risky, and also the Obersalzberg region where the Berghof is was a Nazi stronghold during the Second World War, and access to the region would have been extremely difficult. The area would have been patrolled by guards and the SS, and surely the Nazis would have planned about how Hitler could have been possibly assassinated at the Berghof. The area though is full of mountain peaks and trees, and it would only take one person, armed with a gun, to remain undetected in the area. Interestingly also, there are a number of mole bunkers around the Berghof. These were where SS soldiers would shelter during an air raid, which suggests that there are a number of SS soldiers in a distinct area of the Berghof. There are also so many other factors to look at when considering the assassination attempt, such as the weather on the day, or so on. Obviously poor weather could have prevented Hitler's walk, but also played a huge effect on the bullet's trajectory, would it have been fired? But who knows? It's definitely an interesting operation to consider and look at. I hope you've enjoyed this look at Operation Foxley. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. Once again, thank you for watching.